So the self or the consciousness doesn't undergo any change. Everything appears and disappears into self. The morning time, the body and the world appears. The body is the knower, thinker, doer, experiencer, and the world. Both appear together. We have an illusion that I am the body, but in reality, body and the world is appearing in consciousness. And it merges back. In dream, this world disappears, some other world opens up. And deep sleep, both worlds disappear. Okay? So this I can say more like a waves rising and falling in an ocean. Nothing happens to ocean, waves rise and fall. And these waves are so permanent, temporary. So the perceptions rise and fall in consciousness. They are not permanent states. The perceptions rise and fall. Now the perception itself is not real because there is, other than consciousness, nothing is there. Consciousness alone is there. So the perception is not real because it is trying to create a picture in the consciousness. Sky alone is there. The clouds are not real. The clouds are appearing in various shapes and disappearing. It's not there. The sky, nothing happens. Similarly, nothing happens to consciousness. The shape and form are appearing and disappearing. They are not real because they are changing shapes and forms. They are constantly changing. And they appear and disappear because there is no reality to that. What is real doesn't change. But here the constant change is there. Every moment it changes, appears and disappears. So that being the case, okay, there is no reality to that. Unreality appears in the consciousness and disappears. Your question is, is there a deep sleep state also? Is changing state? Yeah, there are alternately waking state, dream state, deep sleep state are alternating. The deep sleep state also is changing. Okay, but only thing is, in the deep sleep state you experience bliss. Okay, there is a blissful nature is experienced, and this blissful nature is also is called Advaita or non-dual. Okay. It's only pointing to real blissful nature. It is not final. Then the best thing is take a couple of sleeping pills and we'll get enlightened. It doesn't happen that way. Okay? The blissful nature of the deep sleep is pointing to blissful nature of the self. Okay? Even in Atmadhyana, there's a blissful nature. And in deep sleep, also blissful nature. What is the difference? In the Atmadhyana, the ignorance is gone. In the deep sleep, when you go to deep sleep, there's ignorance that I am the body and world is real, that ignorance is there. So the mind has got a subtle form. Okay? So mind has almost, we can say, it's in the closest computer analogy I can give. You put the computer in shutdown mode or hibernate mode. The programs have gone to the dormant condition. Okay, programs are there, they are alive, they are kicking. But the computer screen is blank. Similarly, the mind is like a computer, it goes to a hibernation condition. Okay, when you go to hibernation condition, there is no world, there is no experience. There is no other. It is a non-dual state. But the ignorance in the mind has not gone. Okay, the virus is there in the program. So it is pointing to the bliss of the non-dual self. Pointing to. Non-dual self bliss also is like that. But the only difference between a Jnani and Adnani is that a Jnani, he has killed that virus. Okay. So for him, the virus is gone. Okay. Or rather, virus is corrected. And where does the correction take place? Only in the waking state. It cannot correct in the dream state or deep sleep state. Correction has to happen in the waking state. How through waking state? Through Atmadhyana. So now a program called mind is corrected. So let us say Jnani goes to sleep and Adnani goes to sleep. Okay. Adnani goes to sleep in ignorance. Whereas Jnani through Atmadhyana, he has realized I am Brahman, I am pure consciousness, I am of the nature of bliss. Now he goes to sleep, his mind program also goes to dormancy. Okay, hibernation. But it goes to hibernation with the free from virus. Okay. So and he comes up. Both experience the bliss of the sleep in similar way. But except that in case of Jnani, the mind program is deleted or altered. So because of that, what will happen over a period of time, rather he is not, when he wakes up also, he is not coming back into the program called I am the body. He knows I am not the body and he operates in the world till that impressions or vasanas get exhausted. Okay? The bliss of the self is pointing to bliss of the deep sleep is pointing to bliss of the self. But there is a difference between the Ajnani and Jnani. In Ajnani, there is a mind program which is saying, I don't know myself, world is real, the program is there. So this is a perpetual program, it will keep on going for lifetimes. Whereas Jnani has debugged the program and he has understood, I am the Atma. So this, what we see the world is unreal, mithya, that understanding has come. So because of that, the program will exhaust itself after a timeout. Are we clear? Any questions?
Now,
stop.
Deep sleep, there is a bliss.